Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jillian. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, Joe. In honor of your birthday this year, I'll be doing one good deed every day for a stranger. So I hope you have a good one, and thanks for being you.
Happy birthday, Jill. Keep up those positive, happy vibes. So glad to be part of your team.
Happy birthday. I wanted to first start off with a quick little story about Jill when she was younger. She used to have a birthmark, loved My Little Pony, so my oldest sister, Barbie, thought what a great idea, tell her that birthmark really was where her horn was going to grow out of when she got older. Jill, thinking that she was a unicorn and the last of her kind, grew hysterical that everyone had killed off all her other fellow unicorns. But I've respected and loved Jill since the beginning. I might have not shown it as much growing up. I did scratch off that birthmark. I used to bite her. But I've always tried to copy her. Started off small, just ordering a cherry Diet Coke at a restaurant after she did. But there's so much more to want to copy about Jill. She's one of the most compassionate, lovable, hardworking people I know. I can't imagine not knowing her, and I'm really proud of everything that she's accomplished so far. I just wanted to also thank everyone for coming out and celebrating Jill on this completely random Friday that was chosen for her. Jill, I couldn't love you more. Have a great day.
I love Jill because she's the most selfless, kind, thoughtful, and pure-hearted people I've ever met in my life. And I feel like it's so rare to encounter somebody that, without even thinking, always puts others before themselves. And for that, I'm extremely grateful to have her as a part of my life. Aside from that, Jill's also the best gym partner out there. I don't know if any of you have ever taken a Tone House class with her before, but it's one of the hardest in the city, and she's always there right next to me trying to motivate me and get me to do better than my last time.
Jill, happy birthday! I couldn't do what I do without you. It makes it so much better. The world needs more Jill. I hope you have the best birthday. I look forward to celebrating with you soon. And don't give the guys too much of a hard time for wanting to love you up and give you a good celebration for your birthday. See you soon.
Hey, Jill, happy birthday to you. I am thinking back to the first time that we met when we had lunch on Miami Beach out in the gorgeous open patio. And from that day forward, I just felt like I could call you and talk to you and be friends and talk about life and everything. And you were so sweet to be open and come and have lunch with me and meet me, never having met me before. What I love about you, you are always positive, always smiling. I think with you, anything is possible. You just are so sweet and thoughtful. I think you really can get a feeling of what everybody needs even before they know it. You are so good at what you do. And I love having the chance to talk to you, even if it has nothing to do with David. But so I look forward to our phone calls, our texts, our emails, and let's find ways to visit each other a lot more. Come to Boston, come and visit, do some sightseeing. Anyway, have a great, great day. So happy that we know each other. Bye.
Happy birthday, Jill. I know this isn't one of your favorite times of the year, but it is for all of your friends. We finally get a chance to make a fuss about you the same way you do for everyone else's birthdays throughout the year. Thinking about all of the people that wanted to be part of this special day reminds me how lucky I am to have you in my life. There are far too many amazing things to list about you, so one of my favorites is how welcoming and loving you are to every single person you meet. I am truly lucky to have you in my life, and there's no one else as selfless as you. Happy birthday.
So first, why do I love Jill? Well, Jill is one of those rare people that is always looking to make others happy. She rarely takes time for herself, be it a Diet Coke or two throughout her entire day. And she works more than anyone else I've ever known to make everyone around her feel happy. And then a story about Jill that I love is when Jill was moving places in Astoria, she would text me randomly throughout the few weeks that she was doing it, saying, "Hey, are you around? I just need to move this extremely heavy item. I can do it by myself, but if you're around, I was just thinking maybe you could help me out." And again, like, ridiculous, like, I would go over and see this item that's like this huge, like, 200 pound dresser that Jill was trying to move on her own. And it's just a sign of who Jill is, that she'd do anything to make others happy, and even sacrifice herself to make that happen. So happy birthday, Jill. Hope to talk to you soon.
Happy birthday, Jill. Love you so much. I really wish I could be there to celebrate with you, but I know you're having a great time. I can't even begin. I know I'm gonna start crying already. You know, one of the reasons why I love you so much is that you are so emotional, and everything, you know, really affects you, and you take everything to heart, both good and bad. It's something that, you know, you just are the best person. It's so hard to put this in words, but, you know, I can't even begin to describe, you know, what you mean to me and why I love you so much. You made me a big sister for the first time, and taught me so much. Even though I'm your big sister, you definitely taught me what it means to care about someone more than anything, and you know what it's like to teach someone things and be there for someone. And you know, ever since you were little, you were always there for me. You know, even if you were stealing my dolls and stuff, when you would come back with the cutest little apology letters, and you know, you draw things for me. Yeah, it was just, I can't even imagine, you know, between you and Brittany both, it was, you guys are just my best friends, and I'm so glad that you are my first little sister. I'm so lucky, and, you know, when anyone ever asks, or tells me, like, you work too hard, I'm like, no, you've never met my sister Jill. She works harder than anyone I know. You're so smart and sweet and caring and silly. That's one of my favorite things about you, is that you always know how to make me laugh. And wherever I'm coming to visit you, there's always a bottle of Diet Coke nearby. It just shows how much you really care about other people and all the thought you put into everything that you do. And, you know, I can't even begin, like, my favorite memories of you are just, I mean, I've known you for your whole life, so it's hard to put down. You know, I keep on thinking of more, like, how we used to stay up for Full House, and you were Stephanie, and I just had a random memory of, do you remember the time we went to Chinatown and we were all obsessed with, like, Karopi and all those? I forget which one you liked. It was, like, not the frog. You liked one of the other ones. Like, maybe it was the Hello Kitty or something. But like, we all had, like, our own little thing. And then just running around and looking for trolls and Peter Pan and all the silly games we used to make up and entertaining ourselves, you know, when we had to go shopping, like hiding in the clothing racks. And, you know, there's just so many that, you know, even if I can't remember every single one, I actually remember even when you were, you know, coloring in the old kitchen and then going over to grandma's, which we loved, and then, it's just so many. And like in our kitchen, playing hide and seek. You know, I wouldn't be who I am without you. So, I love you so much. I wish I could be there, but I know you're having a fantastic time. And just remember, anytime, you know, you start to think about, you know, your birthday, which is just a day to celebrate you, but just always remember that I will always be older. So anytime you're feeling sad about your age, just think of me and you'll feel better, I hope. So I love you so much, Jill. Happy birthday, and I can't wait to see you again soon. I'm so glad that we're in the same state again. Mwah. Love you forever, brother. Mwah. Happy birthday.
If you want my future, go get my pen. If you wanna get with me, then it's
happy birthday, Jill.
Now don't go waste
it. I can't remember what spice girl name we gave you, but it's been amazing getting to know you. You've become one of my best friends forever. And you're just like the best person in the world. You're so sweet and wonderful. And I'm actually using words in that emoji, but I'm gonna do it. Anyway, grilled cheese dates forever. I'm so glad that I've gone on so many adventures with you, including our little weird Connecticut bus trip. Yeah, I'm a little at a loss for words. Because you're so special to me.
Happy birthday, Jill. I hope you're gonna take some time off to celebrate your birthday. Wishing you all the best and enjoy it.
All right. I assume everyone has found time to complete their poem, except for Mr. Donovan, who has an excuse. Chef, lose the glasses. All right, anyone brave enough to read theirs aloud?
I will. I hate the way you only eat bagels and have amazing blonde hair. I hate the way there's never enough coffee in the world for us to share. I hate the way you're so into fitness and makes those trips to the Hamptons make me want to drink Guinness. I hate that chicken is your favorite dish, but it must be working since in your floral dresses, your butt is twerking. I hate the way your laptop is always turned on and bright. It makes me want to get you on J-Swipe and swipe a hard right. I hate the way you, Barbie, and Brittany are such good sisters. Now let's have a toast and find all the single ladies a mister. Cheers, Jill, love you.
Hi, Jill, happy birthday. I love you the most because you are so fun to be around and you bring so much joy to our office. Your memory and attention to detail is superhuman. I think that millennial would be completely lost without you. I mean, I know I would be, and I'm really thankful to have you in my life. You're such a great listener. You're so thoughtful. You're so diplomatic and supportive, and just incredible in all situations, work-wise and otherwise. You have super dope outfits, and You're just really great and irreplaceable. The most memorable experiences I have with you all have to do with shipping boxes out. Like that time that Charlie convinced the postal workers to let us finish up like 50 boxes in the distribution center at like 9 o'clock at night. And it was snowing outside. But my most memorable experience with you of late is when we went to the track workout at McCarran, and we were there for like 3 hours and sweaty and so gross. And then we went to the J-Swipe party right after anyway. I think that just shows how hard you were, because after a long day of work and after a long workout, where you totally won, by the way, we also partied super hard at J-Swipe. And I just want to thank you for being such an incredible influence in my life. And not only are you a great role model, but you've become one of my favorite and closest friends with my secrets. And you made me a better human being, and I appreciate you every single day. And I can't imagine being here or trying to run a half marathon without you. So there's all that. Love you a lot. Happy birthday.
I've known Jill for 26 years, so it's nearly impossible to pick the best memory. But truth be told, the golden childhood that we shared together, I wouldn't choose anybody else to have it with.
Happy birthday, Jill. I just want to say that it's been my absolute biggest pleasure knowing you and getting to work with you for so long. When I think of Jill, I think of the most caring, sweet, diligent, empathetic, nice person I know. And I really actually don't think there's anyone quite like you in the world. And I don't take it for granted that I get to work with you. And I mean that very, very seriously. I think back to the times when we worked together, even before MRY, just a bit of emailing, but then really when I came into Mr. Youth in the Chelsea Market office and I was able to sit next to you and think about how happy I was, but really how much you made me feel at home, given it was my first real office job. And I think I'll always be grateful for that. I don't think you really realized how much you helped me through like those first few weeks and navigating certain things and all that. But really just making me feel at home. And I think you just do that naturally. I don't think you really think about it. And it's something very special. And thank you. I hope you have an amazing birthday.
Jill, let me count the ways in which you hypnotize me every single day. My first supervisor, the OG for life, some days I wish you were my only work wife. But the truth is, you're in a league of your own. Your heart, your mind, your spirit, mind blown. I can barely imagine what it's like to be you. So I sit back, relax, and watch, because the truth is you're dedicated, liberated, elevated. Sky high ain't a limit for your education. You got a lot to teach, we have a lot to learn, and it's a privilege to watch your mind go, to see it churn. But let's switch it up for a second, get into your likes. My heart hurts so much when I think about your diet. Grande iced coffee, please. And a venti cup, 2 Splenda whole milk, and a whole lot of love. And don't forget about that extra ice. Diet Coke is life, but we ain't about that spice. Seafood is the worst, but just keep it simple. Tomato, mozzarella, and maybe a little basil. The truth is, when it comes to you, I could gab for hours. I could fill up a room with a million sunflowers. I could blow up balloons and make all the crowns. I could buy you headphones so you never have to hear the sounds about how much we adore you, how much you're loved, about how much you're admired, and simply a cut above the rest. You are the best. Happy birthday, dear friend. Now I gotta go rest. Peace, love, T.
Hi, Jill.
It is an honor to be a part of Jill Appreciation Day. When Yaris invited me to submit a video for this, I was so excited. And I realized it's because It's a gift to be able to give to you because you are such an incredible and heartfelt giver. It's such a rare quality and it's such a beautiful thing to see in a human. You have so much compassion and so much care for those that are around you, and you are so natural with it. You have such a purpose for it. And what I want to tell you on Jill Appreciation Day is that I feel incredibly safe around you, more so than I do with most people. And it's such a rare and meaningful quality, and something that I'm so grateful for, and I can see everyone on the Millennial team feeling the same way. So thank you for what you've given me. Thank you for making me feel safe, and thank you for your love. Happy Appreciation Day, and thank you. I'll see you soon.
Whoa, this is so cool. We could do this on your phone. Anyway, happy birthday, Jill. I hope you have the best day ever, because you deserve the best day ever, because you are perfect in every way I could think about. You are stylish, you are smart, you are hardworking, you are just amazing and an inspiration to me every single day. So thank you for being you, and have the best birthday ever.
Hey Jill, happy birthday. I think the thing that I love the most about you is your dedication to everything it is that you do, whether it's working out twice a day or just working really hard or just going out like crazy. I really admire your dedication to everything in your life and think you're awesome. I do really hope that you're not working out on your birthday, but I'm sure that you are. But anyway, happy birthday, and I'll see you soon.
So my favorite thing about Jill is that regardless of how stressful or crazy a situation can be, she is like unflappable, unbreakable, and still finds a way to be kind and human, and that's an incredible quality to have in a coworker and just to have as a human being, and part of what makes her really, really special. And my favorite memory with Jill was when we were in the Hamptons and she was working on her computer, and I was able to convince her that she could get just as much work done if she was on her computer, like sitting in the treehouse. And then from there she like went into the pool, and then she did other things, and it seemed like she had a really fun day, and that made me really happy.
Happy birthday, Jill! I wish I was there with you celebrating. I'm happy I could take part in this video though. One of the reasons I love Jill so much, and there's a huge long list because Jill's obviously one of the best people everyone making this video knows, is because Jill's one of the most selfless people in the entire world. She cares so deeply about everyone around her in like a very genuine way, and she's also one of the most reliable people I've ever met. I know that if anything ever needed to get done, she's not someone you need to remind or worry about. She'll always do it. So Jill, you are one of the most deserving people to have the best year of your life, and I hope that you do. Love you, miss you.
I think I love Jill because she is an amazing person. When I come into the office every morning, she's usually the first one there, so I never feel like I come into an empty space. I can always rely on Jill when I have a question for something. And Jill, you're great because you're one of those people that I can relate to and can get along with very easily. When thinking about one of my favorite memories, even though I've known you about 8 months, I think I've gotten to know you pretty well with just our little office interactions. You're one of those people that is dedicated to her work, but also to her personal life. And it's clear when we talk about Barry's Bootcamp, which you and I still need to take a class together. So you can just see how both in your fitness world as well as your work world, you're able to combine things that just make it very inspiring to be in a work environment. Anyways, Jill, I'm wishing you the very happiest of birthdays. Sorry I won't be able there to celebrate, but hugs and kisses from me and Cooper. I'll talk to you soon.
I love Jill because she's the most caring, kind, selfless, thoughtful person I know. She's the most enthusiastic person. She sees the good in people, and even though she doesn't always want to see the good in herself, we always see it. I love you, Jill. Happy, happy birthday. And what's the other question? Oh, my favorite memory of Jill with work is when we were on the kids tour together, and she totally saved the day because she was the only one that knew what the hell she was doing in the world of experiential marketing. And then a personal memory is when she came upstate with me and my college friends up to Millbrook, New York, and we explored the farm and the countryside. And again, she was always enthusiastic and just fit right in with everybody. And it was just always so great seeing her. Love you, Jill. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Jill. I want to take this opportunity to just say how much I love and appreciate you and everything you do for me and for everyone at Millennial and for everyone in your life. I don't always get the opportunity to say thank you and to show my appreciation for those things that you do, but it means a lot to me. And I've said this to you before, and it's something that's just really true. You're one of the few people in my life that has been a real teacher, that has taught me so much and showed me so much, and I can't ever thank you enough for that. And everyone has the same refrain when it comes to you. Everyone says the same thing, that you're just the absolute best. Your selflessness and your kindness and your humor and your sweetness just make up one of the best people I've ever met. And it's been a real honor, pleasure to work with you these past couple years, and I feel honored to call you my friend. And so happy birthday. 30 years can feel like a long time, but not when you have so many people around you that love you and cherish you like you do. Cheers to many more years of, hopefully many, many more years of Jill in my life. Love you. Happy birthday.
Jill, don't hate this video. We love you. Have an amazing birthday. I'm keeping this super short and sweet. Happy birthday.
Jill, when I think of you, I think thoughtful, sweet, kind, tough, a wonderful soul, someone who would do anything for anyone and never ask for anything in return, one of the most giving people I know. I'm truly blessed to call you my colleague and friend. So what else is there to say except for happy birthday, Jill? I'm sending so much love. Happy birthday.
I love Jill because she's selfless, kind, thoughtful, and pure-hearted. And I feel like it's so rare to find someone who, without even thinking about it, puts others before themselves. And like literally every time. aside from that, she's also the best gym partner around. Don't get me wrong, she gets pretty competitive, but she also always pushes myself to exceed my own personal bests and give my all, even when I want to give up. As far as a favorite memory of Jill, I don't know if I have just one. I think I have several, but most of them typically involve a beach in some way. She kind of transforms into Happy Jill, kind of a different person every time she's around the beach, and I've never really seen her more relaxed or carefree, and that's kind of just the way I like to think of her.
Hi Jill, I just want to say happy birthday. Thank you so much for everything that you do for the team, for Millennial, for all of us as individuals. It's been so wonderful to work with you, and the fact that you're so dedicated and so passionate and so driven and so kind just really elevates everyone who's around you and has the pleasure of getting to see you almost every day. So thank you so much for everything you do, and thank you for being such a good friend and teammate. I can't wait to keep working with you. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, dear Jill. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Jill. May you continue crushing at life. May this year be the best one yet. Love you, Jill.
Jill, I think it was literally 2 days ago that I was telling the story about how you would walk on the other side of the street of the fire department, but strategically walked on that street just so you could see the firemen. And the day that you decided to walk on the same street of the firemen and say hello, you ran straight to me when you got to work and were just blushing and glowing and giggling and being all Jill. And this basically sums up my love for you in a nutshell. You're amazing and so lovable and so adorable, and I wish you just the happiest birthday, even though you're probably not too thrilled about it from what I hear. Don't be scared, yo. It's gonna be a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful time in your life. And you're killing it. You're killing it. All right, I love you. Mwah.
Happy birthday, Jill. You are the kindest, most caring, sweetest, hardest worker I know. Everyone who I know who knows you loves you. And I'm incredibly lucky that I got to work with you every single day. Happy birthday.
Hey, Jill. Happy birthday. I know you don't want us to admit that it's your B word, but it is. So, happy birthday. I feel so lucky to celebrate another year of you this year and hope to continue to do that so many more years to come. We've had so many great times, from dancing in the rain at the Drift to John Scott's taking ski shots, doing things that we can't really mention in this video together, but we all know the fun nights that we've had out there and in other places. I mean, we've had so many great times together, and I look forward to the many, many more memories that we'll share, the heart-to-hearts, the intense conversations that you definitely don't want to have, but you do. And I hope that we continue to share these wonderful memories together as we grow old and try and stay as cool as we can. Try not to have mice run over our feet or walking around town or spill burritos in trains or eat bagels while God knows what. I love you so, so very much, and I hope you have the best year ever, and wish you a life full of more travel, more love, more happiness, of course, more smiles, and more trips together. And I hope you enjoy this day. Don't be upset at us for doing this video and making this all about you, but you deserve it because you're loved by so many people. So accept and receive. Love you so much.
Jill, 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 Jill. What do I love about Jill? I love absolutely everything about Jill. There is not a speck of anything not to love about. I think Jill might quite possibly be the most lovable person on this planet. She is the most kind, caring, loving, giving, nurturing, determined, supportive, stubborn, amazing, inspiring, friend, colleague, and sister that I never had. But do, and I'm so blessed and thankful for Jill to have been in my life over the last few years, and feel like I'm a better person every day because of it. There's no words to express my love, admiration, care, and deep love for Jill and who she is and what she represents. And really, I don't know, deep. And what are my favorite memories with Jill? There's just too many, so many. They're all kind of crazy though. We'll do a couple. I think one of my favorite memories is my first day meeting Jill in Chelsea Market at the Mr. Youth office when Doug walked me into Jill and Vinny, and within like a little while we were colleagues, and we have, you know, not sort of left each other's side ever since. Jill sort of helped. Jill was my first boss at Mr. Youth, my first or client or best friend, and we worked very closely for very many years, and I learned so incredibly much from who she is and how she does the superhuman things that she does. Lots of it is still actually outside of the realm of physics of the world scientists are not able to understand, but they're working on it. I remember the nights of College Fest where working towards the wee hours of the morning before the show, Jill would be drawing the booths in little squares on a big poster board with like pencil or pen, color coordinated, with a binder that was like a foot large, bigger than all college textbooks combined. And that was basically the sum total hub of our life for many, many months of the year, our late nights and into the wee hours of the morning at the Heinz Convention Center. I remember our trip to Chicago. Jill and I had a nice biz trip to Chicago, and we had a lovely little, I think it was Asian fusion dinner at this really nice little spot. And I really liked that dinner. One of my favorite times one of my favorite experiences with Jill was our original OG Spotify pitch, where it was her and Evan and I, and I think she had a huge crush on Dave. She told us that afterwards, who was on Spotify's team. But Jill really like didn't want to go, but we were like, Jill, you have to go, like this doesn't exist without you. And she came and she crushed it. It was amazing, and that experience really changed our lives from there. I remember the dinner where Jill told us that she would join Millennial and take a huge leap of faith and leave the comfort of the best friends and the dear workplace that we love very deeply, that we both shared for many years before, and you know, sort of the comfort and the known for a little factory in Somerville, Brooklyn, and a bunch of crazy people pursuing a dream. And oh my God, am I grateful for her courage in that one, because nothing would exist in my or this world without Jill's omnipresence, sort of behind the scenes, enabling every single piece of every single thing that happens every single day. No question, she'll deny it, but like, fact, science. And I think my most recent favorite memory of Jill, she doesn't know this yet, but was about last week. We were in the Hamptons, for a team trip, and I got this picture of Jill in her zone, right? For those of you who are not familiar, I can't really see because this is Jill on a pretzel in a pool, just straight chilling, which from this day forth, based on this photo, should only be known as straight Jillin. This is Jill in her happy place, straight Jillin. And inspired by this, Jill, I wish you the most deeply exciting birthday, a year full of joy, love, adventure, courage, strength, journey, seeking, inquiry, and really, really dialing in on the dream, your dream, because all I want every day is for you to be living in the embodiment of your dream, which is likely some form of beach side experience with sun and sand and lots of love. And I love that. And I love you so, 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 so very much. I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. Thank you for everything. Thank you for being you. And till forever.